So what is left for this to do? We need to also add the connections between our inventory and our items. Well, our items we mean inside our controller, basically. Now, let's go on to the level scene, because we do need to take a look at the inventory. Let's see, I think we can just open the game menus. Okay, and let's close that, we don't really need it. Okay, so the problem that we have, quote unquote problem, is that we need to know its slot, what does correspond to. Okay, and the way I'm thinking it, we're going to create, we already have done some things in the past, but I think let's do this again just for making sure we are, you know, in the same page. Okay, we do have the slot type, weapon slot, and so on. Let's open this up. And this gives us, we have an item array variable which assigns items and so on and so on. Now, however, I think I want to make this a little bit differently, because this is very abstract. Okay, we do have the slot type which points to just an array of items, but yeah, it's still pretty abstract. I don't really necessarily like the connection we have from this, and then getting this item and having different list basically for each of the items we're going to need. So we're going to do this slightly differently. Okay, I'm going to create one scriptable object. We're still going to be decoupled from the sender, from the controller. And let's find our controller. Of course, our controller is a prefab inside our resources. We have a network print, our controller, and let's make sure this is the actual controller we're using. Yeah, okay, I think that's the one. Awesome. So, okay, we have our controller and everything else that we're going to need in this case. Okay, you can see the network print. So I'm going to just create a scriptable object that basically is going to have the data we want for this. Then we're going to take that scriptable object and filter it a little bit, because there are some shortcuts. For example, if you only have one weapon on the third slot, you don't go from other two empty slots. You usually only get one empty slot and one for the weapon you have. If you have, of course, slots on all the three, then it's okay, you can do anything. So let's go on to our scripts and let's go and create that first. Okay, we have everything over here, so I guess it's still on inventory. So I'm just going to create this and let's call this character snapshot, because it's basically a snapshot of what items you have. Similarly, this can be exactly like the profile we have, come to think of it. Let's find the profile as well. Okay, but the thing is, the profile we have over here, apart from the right-hand weapon, left-hand weapon, and so on. And actually, yeah, I guess we could just use this as well. But I'd rather just keep the snapshot, because you can reuse the snapshot for different things. But come to think of it, yeah, this is probably going to do the same thing, I guess. So starting value. Okay. Yeah, no, okay, you know what? Yeah, okay, let's go with this then, with the player profile. So, we're going to go with the player profile. That's no issue. So, forget the character snapshot, because I believe we already done the player profile on any character that joins, which means we kind of have already done this work. So let me clear the SAMP. Let's see, character snapshot, player profile, same thing. Okay, so we need a method for what are we going to be loading, or how are we going to be accessing this, all these stats. Okay, and most probably these three lists. We still need a list for consumable items, but we can do that later as well. Okay. So here's what I'm going to do for this. I'm going to do a system non-serialized, and I'm going to assign public. We need a state manager, because from the state manager we can access that, assigned states or just states. We can access our inventory from a state manager and so on and so on. Okay, if we go over here, we're going to go and we're going to see inventory and the rest. Okay, so we can create a method now, public void, assign or update items on states. Let's put this below. And we only need to be updating this from somewhere. Okay, we don't need to have this coupled with something else. But first, we need to know if states is null. Then you can't really update the items, just return back. Now, let's go on the state manager. We do have the inventory. And inside the inventory, we do have the weapons for the right-hand slots, the left-hand slots, and so on and so on. Okay, we can initialize this as 3, just to keep it static. Actually, yeah, okay, let me think. The cloth items are very simple, so let's do those first. So player profile, close that. Okay, so that will mean states.inventory.clothes equals the cloth items you have above. Simple like that. Then, for the right-hand weapon items you have, if right-hand weapons items.i is, first of all, is a weapon, because this is cast as an item. Okay, let's also create a list for weapons, right corner weapons. Okay, and we should cast it that's not how you cast, but anyway, okay, so we do need to know if this is empty or not, because if you remember from our old parts as well, we're not going to have you know, if it's the empty, it's still a weapon. If you don't wear any items, if you don't have anything on your hands, it's still a weapon that you have to basically, you need to have attacks. Of course, then it's going to be punches and, you know, maybe some parry and stuff like that. So we need to know if this is the unarmed weapon. So how I'm going to do this right now, I'm kind of going to hack it, and I'm going to say unarmed weapon. And next I'm going to check for if W is the unarmed weapon. Okay. If it is, we're not going to do anything. So maybe let's make it smaller. So if it's not the unarmed weapon, we're going to add it on your right hand weapons dot add the weapon. Now, because we have this, we could basically just, you know, get weapon actuals from list. And we need to pass a list of items. And then we can take all of this, cut it, paste it in here, rename this to return value. Okay, change this to all of this. Oops, not all of this. We want this to be on our list, this, and of course, this. Because it's a list, actually, yeah, this can just be an array, come to think of it. Okay, return our return value. So what this does is basically adding a list. It's finding the actual weapons that are not the unarmed weapon and it's adding them on a list. Which means if I go over here and say that my return value dot count, okay, equals 0, then that means my list is empty. So I'm just going to add the unarmed weapon. Else, if return value dot count is higher than 1, or actually is lower than 2, or maybe we can just do it's lower than 3. Yeah, add return value dot add the unarmed weapon again. Now, one small problem. This is not going to keep it like, yeah, I guess. No, okay, we're going to move forward with this. So basically what this does, if you don't have any weapons, you have now the unarmed weapon. If you have less than 3, so that means you either have 1 or you have 2, then you're still going to have the unarmed weapon choice. But if you have 3, of course, or more, then you don't need to be doing, you don't have an empty slot for your unarmed weapon. So with this, we can just go and say on my states.inventory.righthandweapons or right hand slots here, yeah, okay, is going to be get weapon actuals from list right hand weapon items dot you pass that as an item. Get weapon actions from list. What are we missing? That will return us this. Okay, so this needs to just be an array. Okay, copy that. Left hand weapon items. Left hand, left hand slots. Left hand weapon items. Now there is some more logic that we have to do with this that has to do with the left hand. So if you don't have anything, or if it's the unarmed weapon on your left hand, then you need to filter the action so you are using from the right hand weapon and so on and so on. But that's something we can worry about later. Okay, so we now have the right hand slots, we have the left hand slots. Okay, and we also have our cloth items. If we go onto our inventory, we should have. Let's pin this save, and here's our inventory. And we probably have an init or something. We do have the set weapons. Okay, we do have all of these. Okay. Okay, so I think we are running the init from a state action. So let's take a look on the state actions. AI action, this is for AI, we don't care for those right now. State actions. Init inventory. Okay, so all of this runs and updates the character viz and so on. Now, because of the nature of our init inventory and how this actually works, because it's a scriptable object, which is also state action and so on and so on, here's what you can do. You can just go on the player profile, and I'm going to assign a public init inventory. I can either assign a state action as well, okay, but init inventory, I think it's going to avoid errors. Because you all can only assign an init inventory and not any other state action you want. So after we have updated all our states, we can just go and say init inventory action. We need to pass the states, and here we are. And yeah, init inventory actions.execute, that is. And here we are. We have updated our action. Okay, we can take a look a bit over here and see what we have. We do need the resources manager, okay. We have the unarmed weapon as well. Okay. This goes through all of them and assigns them. I think, however, this doesn't clear the any previous items we have, so we're going to have to clear those as well. Okay. We're not going to do it progressive, so it looks, if you have a weapon already and clear it, we're just going to go clear them, all of them, right away. If we have to do this, if we have to update all of them, and if we have performance issues that we're going to have to clear one by one, then we're going to do it there. So, for that, we can go onto our inventory. We have all of this, and we can just go and say public void clear all items. Mostly this will have to do with the right hand slots, left hand slots, cloth items. We don't create anything for them, so doesn't matter. And carrying items, I believe that's also the same. So for right hand slots, let's do it for each, because why not? Item or weapon, better yet. W in right hand slots. If W dot thing it's runtime dot model instance. Yeah. Just destroy it. And for that to destroy, we need to go via game object. Okay, we don't have to clear them because it's still going to be the same thing with the references are going to be unhooked, so it's going to clear it, you know, the garbage collector is going to take care of that. So back to a player profile then. First thing we're going to be doing is states.inventory.clearAllItems. Okay, so this takes care of the previous weapons, this adds the new weapons, our clothes, and this will execute again the init inventory action. So all that's left is how we populate these two, these three in this case, and any other items we have onto here. And now it's where we're going to connect the UI Inventory Manager with all of that. Okay, so first thing first, we have our UI item slot, which is here, and we do have our UI slot type. Then I'm going to remove this. As you can see, and if we do a final references, we're not really doing this. We're not really using this anywhere. I think slot containers, we're not even using them anymore. So we can ignore this entirely. And I think we can safely delete this. I don't really care to work with this. But here's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to use the UI slot type right away. I'm going to make it into an abstract class. And let's delete the create as a menu because we can't create it anymore. And I'm going to say public void load item. Okay. All I'm going to keep, however, is a public integer for indexed on list. Okay. And you know what? No, I'm not going to keep this over here. I'm just going to pass this as an index. And this is going to also be an abstract void. Abstract void. Okay. Now, on our UI slot type, I'm going to just go and expand it. The abstract method, which we have over here. And I'm going to say, let's see, where is our slot type? Okay, it's down here. Add a new class. Find our scribble object. And we're going to add UI slot weapon slot type for first. Now, because we have two cases of this, and this will now be UI slot type, we can go and say create as a menu UI weapon slot type. Okay, because we have two cases of this, I'm just going to keep is left hand. Going to do it like this. We need to implement the abstract class, which is down here. So I need a reference to my profile right now, and I guess we could just be using this from the load item, so let's do that as well. State manager. Actually no, we need only a reference to the player profile, so that will be player profile. Player profile. Okay, then player profile. Player profile, and if is left, then player profile dot left hand weapon items. Let's see, left hand weapons. Okay, left hand weapon items. We don't need the strings, we're only using them for initialization properties, so we don't really care. So left hand weapon items index dot, and yeah, as you can guess, we also need the item, target item, weapon items target item. Okay, copy this. Change that to right hand weapon items. Okay, we need to change the base class as well. So do a pick definition and pass the items item over here. Okay, and here we are. So we basically, that's how we're going to be loading from the slot type to our player profile with just this method. This method is agnostic, which means we can just go on the UI item slot, have the slot type. We are doing a load item, we just loads icons inside the inventory method, and we can go. Unfortunately, we do have to pass the player profile as well. Player profile. And we also need a public integer over here for the index in the list. So let's let's say it like this. Which means I can now go back to slot type dot load item, list index, player profile, and my target item. So whenever now we're calling the load item, let's see, from all of these, they're all in the same place, which is the UI inventory manager, which just means I can just come over here, add a player profile reference, player profile, and let's call it local player profile. Local player profile, and I just need to pass this over here. Now, null, we should probably do a case for the null. So I'm just going to pass the local player profile for now. Local player profile again. And down here, local player profile. Let's go onto the player profile. And let's do a cases for null. Although, if the list entry is null, it's never going to be a weapon, which means this will still count. Okay. So, we have a method to update this to. We need a method that actually runs the update items on state. On the UI inventory manager then, on select equipment slot, let's see. So basically I'm just going to run it as let's see, do we have a tick? Yeah, we do have a tick. Okay, inventory navigation, equipment allocation. So here's what I'm going to just say. I'm going to do a bool update inventory. If update inventory, update inventory, then false, and then local player profile dot update items on states. So after any of these runs and executes, so basically over here, update inventory equals true, and down here, update inventory equals true. Okay, it's going to be forcing an update on all the states we have, on all the items and so on and so on. Now, the only case that's left is that we do need to have a reference on our local player profile onto our states. So how do we do this? We have our input manager, which we know is here. And if it's not init, equals false. Let's see where does init run. Is init equals true? This runs on start, which is not the most ideal place to run this. So we can say if states dot, you don't have the states, so if player profile or local player profile dot states equals null, local player profile dot states equals input dot player states, but state manager, that's a variable. Or, because this is the local, because we also have this as state manager variable. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to go onto our player profile on the states. We can just change this to a public state manager variable. States manager variable states, and we're just going to have to add states.value to this. Dot value. Okay, and instead of checking for this, because this we're going to be assigning this from the inspector, I'm just going to say state of value. Now, on our UI inventory manager, we can delete this. We don't have any need. And even if this is, if our states have not yet been initialized, we're going to say that, you know, it's going to be like this. But if we are going to use, we need to know if we are actually successful in updating. Otherwise, we would like, we maybe would like to, you know, keep trying until it's assigned. So return true over here, and back to the UI inventory manager. We're going to say if local player profile dot update items on states, then inventory update inventory equals false. Otherwise, keep trying until the states have been assigned. Okay, so minimize that, and now we're going to have to set up a few things. First of all, we only have the weapons. Let's see. Yeah, okay, we don't need this anymore at all. So let's delete the entire method. We're not going to be using containers anymore. So, okay, and we need to go onto our inventory. We have our weapon slots. These are the first ones. Okay, and we now need to go and assign slot types, of course, which means we can we're going to have to go onto our project and onto our let's see, data. We have our UI slot types. All of these now are corrupted, or they don't really exist anymore. That's where we get this null reference from. We can do create UI weapon slot type. For these three, and better yet, let's say this as right hand weapon slot type. For the first three, we're going to assign this on the slot type. Okay, it's not left. Then duplicate that to left hand weapon slot. And of course, this now is going to be the left one. And down here, we're going to assign that three, the left hand weapon slots. Okay, next. List index 0, 1, and 2, and again 0, 1, and of course 2. If you're feeling adventurous, you could just use the X, I guess, but let's not be that adventurous today. Okay, so we have our weapons slots. Okay, next we need onto our UI inventory manager, we need to assign the local player profile, which is this. On the player profile, we're going to have to assign, let's add a little bit more weapons, I guess. Wear cloth items, let's see. Let's say axe, okay. Just to have some weapons, don't really care. And okay, down here then we need player state manager. Init inventory action. And the unarmed weapon, which is going to be this. Let's change this to sword. We don't have the carrying items. Oh, no. Okay, we do have them. So let's maybe assign. I don't know if we're actually using this, however. So maybe let's just remove the second sword. So we have a sword and axe. Don't know if we are creating this. I'm going to find it in a bit. So close the game menu. If we didn't forget anything, hopefully we haven't. Close the game menus. Okay. Open the game UI. Okay. Save. Unload the scene. Click play. Start game. Enable that. We're not loading the items from our character to the inventory just yet. We're doing it the opposite way. So let's see. Let's see. How was that? Yeah, so I think we're missing something. Which one are the attacks? So it's the Z. Let's see our console. Yeah, so I think I've lost. Yeah, we lost our connection for whatever reason. It doesn't open the items. So let's debug. Game menus, inventory manager. Open this up. We should be running a tick without issues. Equipment navigation down here, okay. And if you're pressing the X input, if current slot slot type, yeah, I think probably current slot is off. UI item slot, okay. Slot type is not null. Let's see what we have over here. On select, target slot. Okay, target slot. Oh, yeah. We need to go onto all our weapons. Because we removed the slot types, we need to go and set up all our items back with a new slot type. Which comes with an issue, as you can see over here, because we now have two different weapon slots. But, as we say here, there's another way around, which means we can just go onto our UI item slot. And I'm going to create a new, actually, weapon slot type. We're going to keep this over here. I'm going to copy this entirely. And I'm going to make a new class. Okay, create new class. Which is going to be weapon slot list or child or whatever. So paste all of this in here, change this into UI weapon slot child, and this now is going to derive from UI weapon slot type, and it's going to override the load item. So, back here, I'm just going to remove the left hand and I'm going to make this an abstract class again. So, you can go down here and this will also be, although I think, let's see if we could do it like this. Yeah. Okay. So, this is going to be another class that is going to control all our weapons, but the actual placement is going to happen onto this, onto the child class. Okay. Now, only problem is that we still need to go and assign them again. Yeah, no, actually that's not going. Yeah, come to think of it, this is going to bring us. Okay, yeah. I know what's going to happen. We're going to go and create the UI weapon slot type. It's not going to be an abstract class. It's going to be a normal class. It's going to have some a body to this, but we're not going to be running any logic for this body. Let's create the menu name, UI, weapon slots parent. Okay, so we're going to be using this for anything that we need to say that it is a weapon. Doesn't matter if it's left or right hand, of course. So down here we need to delete these two. And we're going to create a UI weapon slot type. This is the parent class. It's a weapon. And actually, no, this is the child class. So left weapon slot child, right hand weapon slot child. That's not how you write child, but anyway. Left weapon slot child, okay, tick that, and then right click, create UI weapon slots parent, and this can just be, it's a weapon. Now back to the inventory, we need to go and assign them again. Unfortunately, well, not unfortunately, we brought this on ourselves. Sender left equipment weapon slots, and then we have right hand right weapon slots, okay, and then over here we have left weapon slots, and now we need to say that all our weapons are items, what type of items they are, which means we need to go onto our items. So that will be items, axe, sword, and assign the UI slot type as the top class. Okay, so thus, if this gets a little bit confusing, this is all just inheritance stuff. Okay, but basically because both of these classes are this class. Okay, and because we can go from parent to child, we don't really care if it's left or right hand weapon, we just need to know if it's a weapon. And that's what we're going to be comparing with. So, back to this. Back to our UI inventory manager. What this is going to tell us is that it's going to look that the target slot type we have, if it's the same as the item slot type, and it's going to find all the typed items we have. Okay, this is all the magic of inheritance. Okay. So again, open that, and it still doesn't work. Okay, let's put a breakpoint to this. Attach the Unity. Okay. Did it attach? Or it's trying to, yeah. Okay. And let's see. Oh, we're not even going in. There we are. Slots.items.count. Okay, let's step over. It's not equals. Let's see what values we have inside our items. We have the axe, so that's an issue. That should have worked. I guess the inheritance doesn't. Maybe it's because it's Yeah, I know why. Because this compares the actual, this compares the actual asset and not the type. Okay, so slot type, get type, slot type, get type. And I'm actually going to be impressed if this this is actually going to work. So that was a little bit of tricky thing. And to be honest, if this works, it's all come from experience. Because scriptable objects are assets unit. If you compare an asset with an asset, unit is not going to look out on its type, it's going to look on the actual asset. So it's basically saying that this file is it the same as this file, which always is going to be false. Okay, at least we got another reference to this. And let's see where this is. Huh. Okay. Let's put another breakpoint. At least, yeah, well, at least we know that this now is going to be an issue. Okay, and we are over there. Okay, let's go and find it again. And let's see. Get type. This is not null. Okay, let's hit next. Awesome. Next. And this gave us an error. Yeah, this gives us an error. This gives an error because let's see which is null. The slot items I slot type. Huh. So I think one of our items doesn't actually have a slot type, which you can't get the type. Let's see if that's true. Okay, so items, weapons. Oh, yeah, it's the clothes that gives us the issue. So, you know what? Let's go and create another UI slot type, which is just going to be our UI cloth. Open that. UI cloth slot. Cloth, so cloth slot is actually even more far trickier than this, because we're basically going to have to create four different slots. Okay, so that we can compare, so that we assign them on the correct position. But let kind of how I think of this. No, okay, I think we're going to be fine with this. Okay, anyway. Okay, let's do this. Let's do close the next time. Because it might get a little bit confusing right now. We're just going to create the UI item slot. Not UI item slot. The slot type. Okay. Implement the abstract class, and we don't really need anything at the moment. There's a menu name, UI, not sloth, cloth type. So basically, I think I might even add an enum over here or a body part comparison on the next one. So we don't have to create entire a lot of these cloth slots. So let's go onto our data. Slot types. Let it compile. Create UI cloth slot. Yeah, Yeah, okay, and then we need onto our clothes, select all of this and just assign this over here, because we're going through all of our items and looking for a slot type. Alternatively, if we didn't want to bother with this, of course we could have done if items I dot slot type is not null. Okay, this could work as well. That would have worked too. Save that. Now, the inventory on the cloth slots, we haven't yet assigned them. So if you go and select over there, you're going to get an error. Okay, so don't do it, at least for the next part. Open the inventory. And we're not getting an error, which is fine, but we're still not getting anything else as well. So, there are breakpoints. And that, maybe this doesn't work. We'll see. Okay, and continue. Okay. Let's move. That's the power. And let's see why. This is a UI cloth type, slot type. UI weapon slot. Oh, it compares it as a UI slot type. The base should have worked though, shouldn't it? Yeah, actually, if that would have worked the way I thought was thinking of it, then that means all UI slots, all slot types will have been the same. So system get type. I wonder what's going to happen if we use get type. I guess we'll just have to see. Okay, well, the desperate measure will be to just keep bulls, you know, if it's this, then do that, if it's this, then do that, and so on, or just add enums. But I'm going to leave that as a last result. Okay, so that's the working. Let's see what this get type now is going to give us. Maybe just an oxymoron, but you never know. Okay, get type. So, this still gives us the weapon slot. Okay, so I'm going to try something wild over here. And I'm going to go on my slot type. On where is the slot type? And I'm going to do public UI slot type. Get, actually for this to work, it would have been a public override get type, and this will return us, is it a get type? Does not hide an accessible memory, the new is not required. Yeah, we don't have the get type for whatever reason, because I don't know. Anyway, it's going to return me this. Okay. And this means the superclass. But because it's public, you're going to be able to access it from all child classes. We're still going to be getting the... No, this... Yeah, no, forget about this. It's entirely wrong because it's wrong because we're still on an assist, yeah, we're still on an asset base because these are scriptable objects. If these were classes, we wouldn't have an issue. This would have worked perfectly, but scriptable objects, as I said, are assets. So the comparison is done asset by asset and not by type by type. So that's a bummer. But we can do this simpler. We can still keep all of this. I'm just going to create an enum. Let's do this here for now. Public enum, item type, weapon, cloth, item type. Okay, then on the items themselves, item type. I was hoping to avoid this, but I guess desperate times call for desperate measures. So we don't even need to worry about the slot type anymore onto the items. So let's go and delete that. Okay, and we can delete this. Now we're going to be having an item, and for this we're going to remove that, and we're going to say item type equals slot type item type. Okay, so let's see if we got any errors. Okay, then close that. On to our cloth. Cloth. Change this to cloth. Weapons, weapon, weapon. Okay. Awesome. And then just on this. Short. Item type. Okay. Weapon and clothes. Select all of that. Cloth. Okay, now if this doesn't work, we shouldn't have a reason why it shouldn't work. I'm going to to end the video regardless. Okay, let's see. Yeah. So here's the thing. If we remove this now, this is the wrong UI item slot. Yeah, okay. So we need to add a public bool is inventory, and if it's not the inventory, or better yet, if is equipment. So if this is an equipment slot, only then load on the slot type. Otherwise, it's just a visualization for the selection, so we don't need that. We can run this now as well. It's just not going to do much. Just not going to connect it to the player. Start game. Okay, now we do have this. Clear all items. But basically, because we might not have something in this, we can just say if not equals null, because in the list that doesn't mean that you're not going to have null places. Okay, weapon W not equals null. Yeah, we don't need. Okay, so before we forget, let's go and change this, and I think we're done with this part. So before we forget, however, let's go onto the game menu. Get menus, inventory manager, inventory, center, left, equipment, weapon slots, and actually all of these slots now need to be set as equipment slots. Yeah, I realize it might not be that dynamic, but if it works, it works. It's not like you have a new inventory in all Souls like games, so you know, I don't feel that bad about it. So, and that's it. And just for fun, let's see where else we're going to have to. We're going to find an error. Okay, still on clear items. Oh, because you might not also have a runtime. Why is that though? Okay, so I'm just going to add this as well over here, and when we get back on the next part, we're going to finalize connecting the items to the player, and then we need to do it the other way. So, as always, you know what to do. Like, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one. Of course, feel free to support me on Patreon, as many of you have been doing so for this many years. I'll see you on the next one.